I like misty mountains. I like trickling streams, and I like bright colors. My favorite things are, of course, my blue face, natural eyeshadow, my nostrils that face forward, my sexy lips, as well as my sleek and silky bright golden fur. I am a Shennongjia Golden Snub-nosed Monkey. You must feel honored to meet me. That's because I'm an endangered and rare species that receives Class A national level protection, just like pandas, which means I'm a real national treasure. Getting to know me is also of great significance for you human beings in understanding your own evolution. Okay, so first of all, let me give you some knowledge. We golden snub-nosed monkeys are one of the non-human primates with our habitats at the highest point above sea level. We belong to the Old World monkey family of primates and in the Colobanae subfamily. We are a subspecies of the Sichuan snub-nosed monkey. There are now 5 species of snub-nosed monkeys in the world, namely the Sichuan snub-nosed monkey, the Yunnan snub-nosed monkey, the Guizhou snub-nosed monkey, the Tonkin snub-nosed monkey, and the Myanmar snub-nosed monkey. The first 3 are unique to China. And now, allow me to introduce our big family to you. My home, Shennongjia, is located at 30 degrees north in the west of Hubei province. It has an average elevation of 1,700 meters above sea level, with its highest peak, Shennongding, known as the Roof of Central China, rising to 3,106.4 meters above sea level. Shennongjia Global Geopark is well known all over the world. This is the world's only well-preserved northern subtropical virgin forest area at a similar latitude. It is also an important area of biodiversity, not just for China, but for the whole of planet Earth. This is my home. Spring always arrives here a little later than other places. In late March and early April, the mountain peaks still have white snow on their tops, while spring has already quietly come to the feet of the mountains. We are the ones who can first sense the arrival of spring. We have a special affection for spring because most snub-nosed monkeys, myself included, are born in the springtime. Hey, look! This is a new member of our family who arrived this spring. And this burly fellow with the dignified expression, sharp eyes, and 2 small pink meatballs in the corner of his mouth is our dad. As the head of the household, he's responsible for defending our territory and protecting the members of the family, while taking care of the babies is the thing my mother is good at. Bringing up the little ones is really difficult for my mother. Fortunately, we are a big family with a harmonious relationship. The aunts will take turns to look after the children, grooming them, feeding them their milk, and sending them off to sleep. Baby monkeys are the bonds that hold the family members' emotions together. They can break down boundaries between different families and get them to have fun together. Like you humans, no one can resist a cute baby. By the way, the zoologists say that this behavior of us caring for other people's babies is called aunt behavior. We have aunts, and of course uncles. But my uncles aren't able to be near us most of the time. In human terms, these uncles would be called single bachelors. This is because our marriage law is based on polygamy. One family consists of one mighty and strong male monkey and several adult females, as well as a certain number of young monkeys and baby monkeys. Some grown male monkeys who do not yet have their own families live together with male monkeys who have already been parents and have gone back to being single. Together with our extended family, they form a big golden snub-nosed monkey family, or a golden snub-nosed monkey community. In the whole of Shennongjia, I have more than 1,470 partners. This is the heavenly land that we rely on to live. There's also a story about this place that's been circling among you humans for a long time. The earliest ancestor of the Chinese people, the Yan Emperor Shennong, researched all of the plant life here and taught the people how to farm. Over time, this place came to be known by its current name, Shennongjia. The complete eco-geographic environment here has nurtured a well-preserved green treasure trove at a latitude of 31 degrees north, and also created the homeland on which we depend. Time sure does fly. In the blink of an eye, summer has arrived. This is the season of peace of mind and enjoyment, while the adults are snoozing in the sun. Us naturally lively ones like to show off our strong skills. The little ones also learn from us. They leave their mother's arms and study hard to learn the skills needed for survival. Of course, baby monkeys don't leave their mother's sides for too long, because our natural enemy, the goshawk, often lurks in places where baby monkeys are nearby. The whistle monkey has to pay attention to the skies at all times and send out a timely warning whenever there is any sign of enemy activity. Have a guess. Who do you think I'm most afraid of in our big family? Okay, let me tell you. It's my dad. He'll start fighting with someone else at the drop of a hat. He makes threatening gestures, and he can shout really loud. My mother said that when I was a child, as soon as my dad approached me, I would be so scared that I would scream and go straight into my mother's arms. I was so scared. But then again, if anyone dares to bully us, my dad will immediately rush out to protect us. It's at moments like that when I feel like my dad is just awesome. Just like you human beings, our lives are very regular. We get up at dawn, go to sleep when it's dark, and we even have a nap around noon. Usually we take breaks as a group and protect the young baby monkeys by putting them in the middle. Is this the unity and friendship that you often speak of? Of course, the single bachelors often live alone outside the extended family. I can read their thoughts just by looking at the expressions on their faces. I want to go home! Autumn is my favorite season. The fruits all over the mountains and valleys are ripe, giving off a charming mellow scent. Eating fruit and hanging out in the autumn wind, jumping and playing in the woods. What a nice life! In this season, the monkeys put all their effort into eating. You should know that autumn is the season we've been looking forward to for a long time. Autumn has a special significance for us golden snub-nosed monkeys. It's the time when our hormone secretion is at its most vigorous. It's the best time for making the next generation. Oh, by the time spring comes back around, there will be new members of the family. I'm hungry. I'd better go and look for something to eat. Even though we have well-proportioned figures and trim waistlines, we spend more than 6 hours every day eating. If I put a video diary up on TikTok, would everyone be calling me a bottomless pit because I eat so much? Our stomachs are very special and can digest as many as 170 different kinds of plants. Androsace Henry, clubgrass, glows on the old branches of trees on the mountains or on the high mountain rocks, and is one of our most important foods. The time we spend on gathering and eating cloudgrass accounts for more than half of all our feeding time. Sometimes, we also eat some soil to supplement the mineral elements that are not available in plants. When foraging on the ground, we must be wary of bears at all times. But then again, there's no way I could ever bring myself to compliment those clumsy bears on their tree-climbing abilities. Look! How silly he looks! The forest provides us with food and a living environment, but it is seriously affected by the seasons. We get to eat loads of food in autumn, but as soon as it passes by, it's time to start suffering through the long winter. Winter is a great threat and challenge for us, as we rely on the forest for survival. The winter scene in Shennongjia really is what you describe as 1,000 miles of ice covered in snow. Our little friend, the giant salamander, who is also a national treasure, climbs into the depths of a cave at this time to begin his hibernation, while us golden snub-nosed monkeys embrace the snow-filled sky with open arms. In order to withstand the cold, our fur gradually becomes thicker and takes on an even more golden color. Almost all simian animals have the habit of getting rid of the parasites and dirt on the surface of their skin. Mom! Come and comb through my fur for me! Oh, that feels great! Hey, don't you know? Grooming is a magical weapon that strengthens the emotions between our family members. There is a strong hierarchical relationship between us. For example, my mother and aunts will do my dad's fur, and my dad, or lazy bones as I call him, just sits there and enjoys himself. My mother and aunts take care of each other's fur. They are very friendly to one another. My mother says that when the snow comes, we must stick together in groups to keep warm. Having a loving home is the only way to stand up to the cold. My dad says that only golden snub-nosed monkeys who have experienced the snow have what it takes to become a brave monkey king. But if you want my opinion, winter is just too unfriendly. Look at this thick ice on my fur. Oh, it's so annoying. But what I hate the most is being hungry. Oh, how I wish it was still autumn. After suffering through the cold winter, we welcome spring, which is full of life. The trees begin flourishing, and the flowers start blooming again. I've also grown up. My mother tells me very seriously, "Son, from now on, you have to leave the monkey group and start living independently." Oh well, I guess I'd better go and join the single bachelor club with my uncles. This is not going to be so easy for me. I have to think of a way to defeat a family leader before I can have my own family. That's a little harsh, isn't it? Well, I guess if you don't want to be alone, you have to fight hard. Oh, by the way, there's something interesting I have to tell you. When we are foraging, we are often scattered about here and there, and not able to see each other for long periods of time. But it seems that everyone always knows where everyone else is. Do you know why? Well, as it happens, we communicate by speaking to each other just like you humans do. We can use a variety of calling voices to exchange ideas with each other. Saying things like, "There's food over there!" "Woo woo, watch out! There's danger about!" And the most important thing you can say, "Hey, I'm over here!" Yes, we are the spirits of Shennongjia. For thousands of years, we have been here in the endless, precipitous mountains of Shennongjia.
Beneath the warm eyes of mankind,